Sometimes people are like, you should write a book. And I'm like, no, I'll never write a book. I could maybe hire someone to write a book for me if I just talk.
Oh, you did so good.
Guys, good morning. Welcome to the vlog today. I tried to skip my workout today, but Frank isn't gonna let me. What's going on? You want to work out? Why do you want to work out?
Because I want to get strong.
So you can beat me in wrestle fights?
Yeah.
Okay. April went to the temple this morning. All the kids are off to school. I was getting an early start on the siding out there. It's going well. And But I'm gonna take a little break to, I'm excited to see this thing done. It's looking so good. The siding looks awesome. I've never done this kind of siding before, but I'm just figuring out how to do it. Me and YouTube, we can do anything. But first, exercise on the treadmill. Oh yeah.
But Dad.
What?
Can you get my ready for me?
Can you get what?
Can you get your
treadmill ready?
Yeah.
Yeah, let's go. Let's go out the secret door. It's just your size, right?
Yeah, but look.
Oh, yep. Yeah. Boom. Okay.
Watch. I can barely go through it.
But I have to duck down, huh?
Yeah, because you...
Okay, on the treadmill. Let's get yours turned on. Wait, I think it's on already. Yeah.
Yeah.
Here he goes, Frankie on the treadmill.
I got this number two.
Learning how to use it. Being careful, always wearing shoes. Nice job.
Whoa.
Kind of weird, huh? Oh, kids learn. They learn from you whether you're teaching them or not. I have never said, hey, you gotta go work out, Frankie. But he just sees me out here often and he's like, yeah, that's a thing. I wanna do that. So make sure you're teaching your kids not with just with your words, but with your actions too. They're gonna mimic a healthy lifestyle and eating habits and just all the things. Teach your kids. I joke with my kids and I say, do as I say, not as I do, but they're gonna learn from you what's important and how you spend your time. That's a good way to gauge what's important in your life is how you're spending
it. Nice.
Okay, we're all done. Good job, Frank. You get any muscles yet? Oh yeah. 40% incline. Frank can handle it. Okay, I've been out here working on the siding. It's going really good. It's really not that bad. You know, it just takes some planning and I don't know that I bought enough material. I might need to go buy some more material, but got this whole side and this whole side done. And I still got the back side and the far side over there to do. And we've also got, this is the other thing we're gonna have to run or do today, is this Hayward heater for the pool. The electrician's gonna install a vent, and then the vent is gonna have to go up and out because it emits carbon monoxide. So we had to buy this special kit to vent out that. So I still gotta do that today. I'll have to cut a hole in the wall, probably up in there somewhere.
Anyway, I went with my friend Laura. She does the remarkable journals. And I will tell you, I am not a journaler. I hate journaling. Her journal is the only one I've ever been able to do because it has so many amazing prompts and it's more like filling out like a little paper, and it's small and it's simple. It takes like 2 minutes, but it helps me to get my thoughts out on paper and plan out my day and even journal some things that are happening without having to like write a whole story, because that gives me so much anxiety. I do not like writing it. It will be a miracle if I ever write a book. Everyone's like, I'll tell stories sometimes. People are like, you should write a book. And I'm like, no, I'll never write a book. I could maybe hire someone to write a book for me if I just talk. But I just love her journal. So I hope you guys buy them, buy a lot of them. She has one that she's working on right now for missionaries. And she has one called Becoming. And I just love all of them. The one I use is just the daily. She also has a grief one, which is so good. If you are grieving, or if you know someone that you love that's grieving, it's such a good gift, a thoughtful gift, because it's easy. Like the same as the journaling for that I have right now. It is like an easy way to like put your thoughts into paper, and has the best prompts and helps you. I don't know. It's just great. So Remarkable Journals, I think it's called. Remarkable Me, Remarkable Journals. I don't know. She's great. And the best quote on it I use all the time. It says, remember, what you focus on grows. That's why we say fine gun everything. Focus on that.
Like focus on the shed or the pool house that was sighted today. Not that I forgot about your bread. Let's focus.
I didn't even tell them about that. I asked him to put my bread in when I went to the temple. And when I got home from the temple, let's see, I left it. 8:30. I said at 9:30 put my bread in, and I got home at 2:30. That's 6 hours.
I hadn't even thought about it.
9:30, 10:30, 11:30, 12:30, 1:30, 2:30. That's 5 hours. So it sat here for 5 hours, rising an extra 5 hours.
Daisy walked outside and filmed on her phone my reaction. There's a good explanation, and I'll insert that.
Hey, Dad.
Hey, what?
Did you put Mom's bread in the oven? What?
Why are you telling me?
Because Mom needs to see. What's your explanation, Dad?
Okay. I want to explain something.
Mm-hmm. Explain something
Mom
to me.
Mom will understand this.
Yeah.
And you may understand it as a child. You may not.
Oh.
There's something called the zone. It's where you're most productive when you're just head down, nothing matters, and you're just going for it. And you are rocking that one thing, and you're doing amazing. You know, other things just... So I was in the zone. That's basically what I was saying. I got a lot done. Look, there may not be bread, but...
Yeah, there's split bread, and Mom just barely found out that you didn't put it in the oven. Yeah.
This one, I think I'm going to get words of affirmation, words of encouragement.
Dad, you don't need a contractor. Are you happy?
Yeah, well.
But was that enough affirmation?
Yeah, it's enough. But go work on your mom and make her, show her, like, freak out about how good this is. Like, freak out. Like, in tears, say it was worth it. Okay?
Really sour. But still good. It's just extra soury. I guess a 15-year tradition. They do confection and singing every year. And we're gonna go get, so we paid, it's like $15 for a ticket to get into this. But now that I'm realizing we get a confection, like that's a steal of a deal. Oh, they're cookies. Well, that's actually fabulous. Look at that. It's a cookie and a brownie and some chocolate.
Oh, you did so good! You did so good! was amazing. Stop it. What's not horrible? I'm so good.
Well, let's stop saying you did bad. First of all, she did good. Davey, where are you? She didn't do bad, but she thinks she did bad. And she's glad it's over. Uh-oh. No, but I have to tell you something. $15 for the tickets, but then they came with a plate of confections. That's why.
What's a confection?
The whole thing. It's the fundraiser. The whole thing is like, it's called like Concert and Confections. Carols and Confection. And they do a plate of like, it was like a brownie and a cookie and a mint and a chocolate on the plate.
Okay.
And I was like, okay.
Certainly, like, that's more than any other thing kids go to.
They were like 15. I'm like, 15 a person? And they were like, yeah. And I was like, is there like a family one? And she's like, no, this is like the biggest fundraiser they do. All this, their only fundraiser they
do
all year.
What are they fundraising for?
The choir.
Did they do it? I know, but did they do a trip?
Probably. I don't know.
Thank you.
But like, and or like new equipment, like who knows? It's fine.
Oh, yeah.
But then,
the teacher told us he charged money for the new equipment.
Yeah, like they have a grand piano on the stage. Those are like 60 grand. There was a ton of people there, and then he said this is the 15th year they did it, and I was like, okay, this is like a thing, and I loved it. It was great, and I was like, well, they needed a lead out with their $15, but you get a plate of confections at the end. I would have been like, oh yeah, okay. Because I was just like, holy cow, $15 just to wash into the kitchen. But call me cheap. I don't care. You didn't get any snack break at dance today?
One 2-minute snack.
Did you eat anything during it? Okay, you better eat then. How was dance?
I got pizza though.
Wait, I noticed you're wearing your dance outfit. You look super cute.
Whose locker is this?
Now you're doing homework? Man, you got a busy schedule, EB. I don't know how you do it all.
1, 2, 3.
How many sentences you got to write?
7.
How many sentences you got to write?
8.
You're done.
I have to do an opening sentence and a closing sentence.
Okay, get your closing sentence ready. You're done. Say, in closing.
1, 2.
What is this even about?
1, 2.
You can touch, I can touch snow.
3, 4.
Five. She's doing some homework.
I finished my homework that she gave me yesterday.
Oh yeah, she gave you a long list.
Okay, so
is Dad in trouble still, or did he finish all of his homework?
He had to sign the paper that he wouldn't.
That he wouldn't do short snuggles.
Wait, you got that? What?
She got that.
Okay, Edie, calm down. Okay. Good job, Daisy! Yeah, that's what you're doing. You gotta keep the wheels straight. Are you sure?
Daisy's doing it. Keep going, Daisy, keep going! Don't crash, she's doing it! That's a high fiver. Good job.